and welcome to the New Orleans Jazz and Heritage Foundation's virtual holiday concert. The foundation is dedicated to the promotion, preservation, and perpetuation of the music, culture, and heritage of Louisiana. Tonight, we are glad to present an historical musical collaboration with Dr. Michael White and the original Liberty Jazz Band with the Louisiana Philharmonic Orchestra featuring the wonderful voice of Topsy Chapman. Enjoy.
Welcome to this holiday concert featuring Dr. Michael White, his band, and these fabulous musicians from the Louisiana Philharmonic Orchestra. My name is Bill Grimes, and it is my privilege and honor to stand in front of these great players and work with these great jazz artists where we conflate these two wonderful American art forms. We'd like to start with two Christmas carols arranged by the great Leroy Anderson, sometimes referred to as the Norman Rockwell of the American Pops Orchestra. First, Bring a Torch, Jeanette Isabella, followed by O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Thank you. next song we're going to do, Summertime, is among one of the most popular songs of all times. George Gershwin's masterpiece was originally written for the mid-1930s musical Porgy and Bess. Its connection to New Orleans goes back to 1939, when the great legendary clarinetist and soprano saxophonist Sidney Bechet added a little Creole New Orleans spice to his recording, which became a big hit. You know, a few years ago, I was on tour in Norway with a band, and they said, we have a surprise for you. And the surprise was supposed to be dinner. Well, we had some of this great Norwegian monkfish, which was really good. But then I was sitting next to a little old lady, and they said, this lady is Anne Brown. And it hit me. I said, Anne Brown? Anne Brown was the original Bess in Porgy and Bess, and the first person to ever sing Summertime. So every time we play this song, I think about her. And right now, with a special arrangement with the orchestra strings, here is Summertime.
Thank you.
Right now, the band is going to play a march called Panama. Panama was written way back in 1911 by a guy named William H. Tyers. Everywhere else in the nation, bands were reading the sheet music. In New Orleans, they threw away the sheet music and improvised, and the song became a jazz classic, played by brass bands and smaller jazz combos ever since. The march and its cousin, ragtime, were among the main foundations of early New Orleans jazz. Here is Panama. Thank you. Black church singing was also an important foundation for early New Orleans jazz since the days of Buddy Bolden. The growls, the shouts, the bent tones, the vibrato, and the call and response became an important part of New Orleans jazz horn playing. The hymn we're going to do for you right now is an up-tempo standard hymn called Over in the Glory Land. This song was one of the first recorded hymns in the New Orleans jazz style, recorded way back in 1927 by Sam Morgan's jazz band. Sam Morgan had one of the most popular dance bands in the city, and he remained in the city and recorded here, and he recorded several hymns, and this is among the first. And, you know, I'm happy to say that I discovered that one of my relatives, Earl Fouché, was the lead alto saxophone soloist on this song. And we're going to feature Miss Topsy Chapman on vocal. Here is Over in the Glory Land. Oh, yeah.
Just over into the Lord. Just over into the glory land. Yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your hearts be light. Until then, your troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let the Yuletide's gay. Until then, our troubles will be miles away. Through the years as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years, we all will be together. The fates allow. Until then, we'll have to mutter through somehow. So have yourself a merry little Christmas. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten and the children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, and every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white. Thank you. have a white Christmas, and every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white.
The blues is another very important foundation of early New Orleans jazz for two reasons. The blues vocal effects, like those of church hymns, affected horn playing, and also the common 12-bar blues structure represents many early jazz songs and forms. The song we will perform next, Yesterday's Blues, is an original song that I wrote just a few weeks ago, and it shows that New Orleans jazz is not a limited set of songs, but a style that can be used for endless creation, reflecting elements of today's time and today's life. Here is Yesterday's Blues. Thank you. The next song we're going to do is called Give It Up. This is an original song that we composed a few years ago and has become a favorite of dancers throughout New Orleans. This particular song shows that New Orleans jazz can blend with other ethnic folk musics to come up with new and exciting original songs. We're going to feature Herman LeBeau on drums on this song. We hope you enjoy it. It's entitled Give It Up. It's also known as the Gypsy Second Line. Thank you. One of the legendary figures of traditional New Orleans jazz was a trumpet player named Kid Thomas Valentine. Kid Thomas was born way back in 1896, several years before Louis Armstrong. Wendell Brunius and I had the pleasure and the honor of not only hearing Kid Thomas, but actually playing with him every week for a number of years. Kid Thomas led a popular band called the Algiers Strutters, which was a dance band. And one of the things that we learned from Kid Thomas, in addition to his incredibly unique and individual style, was that almost any kind of song could become New Orleans jazz. Kid Thomas would play rhythm and blues songs and swing era songs and standards and songs like the ones we're going to do for you right now. He adapted this song from a song known as You're All I Want for Christmas, but Kid Thomas turned it into a rousing up-tempo number called Algiers Strut. Thank you. And now for our closing song, one of the most popular blues songs of all time, W.C. Handy's St. Louis Blues. We're going to be joined here by the orchestra, the band, and Miss Topsy Chatman. You know, the St. Louis Blues is one of the songs that became a jazz standard many years ago. And there was a very famous concert rendition of Louis Armstrong's All Stars with the New York Philharmonic and Leonard Bernstein, and that was a classic. And we're going to give you our rendition right now of the St. Louis Blues.
To see that evening sun go down. Yes, I hate to see that evening sun go down. Cause my man, he done left this town. Well, I'm feeling tomorrow just like I feel today. Yes, I'll be feeling tomorrow just like I feel today. I'm gonna pack my grip and make my getaway. Got the St. Louis Blues, just as blue as I can be. Ooh, cause my man got a heart like a rock has in the sea. Oh, she wouldn't have gone so far from me. Thank you. I love his pie. Like the Kentucky Colonel loves his rock and ride. I'm gonna love that man until the day I die. I got the St. Louis blues, just as blue as I can be. Got a heart like a rock cast down in the sea. Well, see, it would never gone so far from me.
We hope you enjoy the performance. We want to thank Dr. Michael White and the Original Liberty Jazz Band, as well as the Louisiana Philharmonic Orchestra and Topsy Chapman for their performance. Stay safe and happy holidays.